Howdy, boys. They call me Dr. Cornmaker, and I have quite a few opinions. I have come to the conclusion that y'all should be eating grain-fed corn stuffed grade-A Angus prime bite. By chance you don't prefer grain-fed corn stuffed grade-A Angus prime bite, you can opt for Butcher Box. Their beef ain't as tender, it ain't as fatty, kinda gamey to be honest, but if you like that kind of stuff, it's pretty good. And for any of you that dare question whether grain-fed corn stuffed grade-A Angus beef is good for you, look at me. I can deadlift a one-ton truck. I used to play rugby against entire teams by myself. I beat a great white shark in a rowing competition from Japan to the great U.S. of A. The United States of America, the greatest country to ever be home to the grain-fed, corn-stuffed, grade-A Angus prime beef. Now, if you are questioning the efficacy of stuffing cattle full of great American corn and soy, the highest quality forage to ever grace our almighty country, that might be slightly poisonous, slightly estrogenic, slightly bad for you. Don't worry about it, cause I'm doing fine. And hey, if you believe those feedlot cattle are being tortured, I believe the opposite. I believe those steers love getting their balls chopped off. You know, it's kind of funny, cause eating grain-fed corn stuff, grade-A Angus beef, will turn your dick off. So in a way, you're cutting off your balls yourself. But don't worry about that, cause I'm doing fine. And my buddies are doing fine. I also believe those steers love living in their own shit, getting injected with estrogen every day. But isn't that what we do anyway? We live in our own shit and suck down birth control in our water every day. But why consume tortured animals? It's what I can afford. Plus that cheaper wild-caught fish at the Asian market is questionable, especially if it's not from the US of A. Some of y'all may be wondering if things like liver or fish are necessary for part of a healthy diet, but I wholeheartedly disagree. I think just meat is fine and dandy. Just ignore all that other ooky-gooky stuff on the animal. We don't care about that anyway. Plus, who doesn't want to sound and look like their face is falling off? Yeah, you know, I've been told my vitamin A is very important to function for every cell in your body, especially skin, activating things like ceruloplasmin, one of those fancy dancing words Mr. Tofano uses. That's dependent on vitamin A. Very important for keeping you looking young, allegedly. Maybe that's why that very bastard Frank Tofano looks so good. Don't worry about it. I'll just get my buddy to plagiarize his videos, and then we'll take his place. No one will know the difference. Don't you dare sell grass-fed meat to my country, boy. And if I wasn't a boy, I have that new lovely little blonde girl at my side. Despite my years of medical expertise and me thinking very highly of my intelligence, I choose to ignore the most important thing in human diets: fat-soluble vitamins. Our government and the sacred RDAs, the recommended dietary allowances brought to us by our Lord and Savior himself, the Seventh-day Adventist demon, are what I adhere by. And in those holy RDAs, they mention no need for these fat-soluble vitamins, despite them being present in every group of human beings ever to exist. But the RDAs are not to be questioned. I pledge allegiance to the great U.S. of A. So be sure to eat meat and drink water, because I need to maintain my $7 million house, my Mercedes for my wife, my Mercedes for my lovely daughter, and she said she wanted a pony, and a pony ain't shaved. You know, despite working for the government and medical establishment my whole life, I suddenly had a change of heart. And I realized that stuffing people full of grain-fed, corn-stuffed, grade-A Angus prime beef would save lives. Thank you, and good luck to you. And sorry, boys, there's a tractor outside. We gotta harvest that corn and soy. Little noisy.